guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl, Precious ADK. I'm a Nigerian YouTuber. I film about faith, relationship, and lifestyle. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about something very personal to me because people get to, you know, ask me this question a lot, and I'm like, why not bring it to YouTube and talk about it? So I get this question a lot, like, people always like, oh, we are into different kind of things. You sell wigs, you sell earrings, you are making air, what else do I do? You're a YouTuber, you're a content creator, like, you do a lot of things. Like, why can't you just focus on one thing, like niche down to one thing? So that thing has been on my mind for a while because I get that question a lot, and I always feel bothered, I feel sad anytime I get that question because I'm like, is it a crime to do a lot of things? Is it a crime? But so last week, people asked me that same question again, so I decided to talk to my coach. And that man is full of wisdom. So I remember something he said, why are you bothered? He said, because that means you have so much money inside of you. God has deposited so much money inside of you that he believes that he trusts you with the work to achieve it. He made the illustration of a particular rich man in the scriptures that he had three servants. He gave one 5 talents, gave the second one 2 talents, and he gave the last one 1 talent. He said the one that he gave 5 talents to, he took the talent and he went to work with it. Then he got back 5 talents more in return. That means, let's say God gave him music. I'm just in an illustration. He gave him music, gave him the gift of drawing, gave him the gift of acting, gave him the gift of playing football, and he multiplied those gifts and he came back with 5 more talents. So the second one, God gave him 2 talents, and he multiplied those 2 talents and came back with 2 extra, making 4 talents. So the last one, he gave him 1 talent. And you know what happened? That one did not make use of that 1 talent. So I was like, that means you have so much on the inside of you. And God could trust you with that. And I was like, you have 5 talents, you think you have talent. What would someone like Aliko Dangote say? Aliko Dangote is into different ventures. He has Dangote Salt, Dangote Rice, Dangote Cement, Dangote Spag, Dangote Noodles, Dangote Maggi, Dangote Seasoning. Name it. Like, he's into different things. Dangote Oil. But he's not venturing into oil and gas. And I'm sure there's a lot of investment that he is that we don't know about. And he was like, then why stress yourself? And I was like, wow, that's true. And I thought of it in that aspect. So why stress yourself? That means God trusts you with so much more. He trusts your instinct. He trusts the fact that you've not let him down. And I'm like, I know a lot of people will go through that kind of situation where your friends will be like, oh, you do a lot of things, niche down. You cannot, you know, before you say that, oh, master of all trade, jack of all trade, master of none. It's a lie. It is our generation. Jack of all trade, master of all. Because if you know how to strike the balance between all of them, you're good to go. So if your friends are like, you are here, you are there, you are everywhere, tell them you are God else. My friends can't relate to what I just said. But the truth is that don't allow anybody to dictate what you can do. Don't niche them because of anybody, because you never can tell the one you will later, you know, end up settling for, or the one you end up, you know, niching or reducing down to. So you can be into oil and gas, you can be into anatomy, you can be into acting, you can be into, as long as you can just track the balance between all of them and know how to balance your life, then you're good to go. Never allow anybody to limit you or restrict what you can do or put inside a box. Because everybody is trying to niche down, so they feel you must niche down. Don't allow them to dictate. Don't allow people to dictate the norm for you. You don't want to create the norm for yourself. Yeah, I tell myself every day, I say, you're an asset. You're not a liability. You create the standard. And if you create the standard, that means you might have to venture into many things and set the standard right in those things. So don't allow anybody to dictate the standard for you. Don't allow anybody to tell you that, oh, this is how it is normally being done. Which one is how it is normally being done? The normal way of doing it is one that set that standard to that level. That means you can correct the standard and make the new standard your own standard. It's very possible. The owner of Facebook, Mark Zuckerberg, he is not the owner of WhatsApp, he's not the owner of Instagram. And I'm sure he has also ventured into that investment that we might know on social media or may not even know about, but we'll never get to hear about it. But you know, I feel like it is the average people that tend to be like, oh, niche down, or the people that are myopic in nature. that will say, oh, niche down, don't do this, do that. They try to dictate the norm for you. Please, never allow anybody to dictate the norm for you. Be your own standard. As long as your standard is not myopic in nature, as long as your standard can see into the future, your standard can check the next 10 years and be like, oh, the thing is, this is just reminded me of the story of Ibuka Oshika, the chairman of Facebook of Nigeria, that she ventured, she studied chemistry in school, and now she has a furniture company. I mean, the chair company, I don't know about company. A company is making sense. She's a multi-millionaire. That's if she's not a billionaire in Naira. So she did not allow the norm of people to be like, oh, you have to study chemistry, you have to work in the lab, or you have to become a lecturer. No, she set her own standard. She knew what she wanted and she went for it. So please, if you know yourself, I think that you can do, you are multi-talented, and you can find a way of striking the balance between all of them, please go for it. Don't allow your friend to tell you, don't allow people to tell you to niche down to one, or niche down to two. Or don't allow your family to be like, your family, your friends, or your parents can be like, oh, you cannot do everything. That's what I love my parents for. They never tell me that, oh, you cannot do this, you cannot do that. They'll tell you, go for it. Go for it. As long as you can strike the balance, go for it. So as long as you can strike the balance, at first it might not be easy. You know, if other people are sleeping for 8 hours, you might have to cut your sleep down to 4 hours, 3 hours. It just comes with the lifestyle of what God has set ahead of you. And for God to trust you with that much talent, that means He knows that you can do it. So please go out with those mindsets. Don't allow anybody to take the standard for you. Don't allow what your friends or society or social media to dictate the standard for you. Because for social media, they believe you just have to just niche down to one thing and you are good to go. Funke Akinele Bello, she's an actress, she's a director, she's a producer, she's a musician, she's an artist. She not all have a record label. So please tell me. She not allow anybody to dictate the norm for her. She's also a lawyer. So please don't allow anybody to dictate the norm for you. Set the norm for yourself. Dictate your standard. And I know you guys, if you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And please hit the notification bell. My goal for this year is to reach 1,000 subscribers and to reach my 4,000 watch hour limit. And I know it is very, very possible. It's you and I. So I'll see you guys in my next video. Enjoy the rest of your week or your day.